Welcome to you all students to my first lecture in chemistry. I hope all will be good. Let me introduce myself. My name is Professor Mrs. Fatima Iqbal Ansari. I belong to Department of Chemistry. So students, let us start with the today's topic. We'll start with the chapter 7th, Modern Periodic Table. So students, today we will study about the Modern Periodic Table. Students, as you all know that there are 118 elements which has been discovered till today, and all these elements have been arranged in the form of a table in order that of their increasing atomic number. Now students, many scientists have studied this element and they came up with different forms of periodic table. But Mendeleev's periodic table is the most convenient and widely used form of periodic table, and it is called as the long form of periodic table or even the modern periodic table. Now students, see the figure. You can see the modern periodic table. Now let us first be clear about the names and symbols of all these 118 elements. Now these 118 elements, I'll tell the symbol and even the name of these elements. So let us start with it. Now you can see the first one, it is hydrogen, H, He, helium, Li, lithium, Be, beryllium, B, that stands for boron, C is carbon, N stands for nitrogen, O, oxygen, F, fluorine, Ne, neon, Na, sodium, Mg, magnesium, Al, aluminium, Si, silicon, P stands for phosphorus, S is sulfur, Cl is chlorine, Ar is argon, K stands for potassium, Ca calcium, Sc scandium, Ti titanium, V vanadium, Cr chromium, Mn manganese, Fe iron, Co cobalt, Ni nickel, Cu copper, Zn it stands for zinc, Ga it stands for gallium, Ge germanium, As arsenic, Se selenium, Br bromine, Kr krypton, Rb rubidium, Sr strontium, Y stand for yttrium, Zr zirconium, Nb niobium, Mo molybdenum, Tc technetium, Ru stand for ruthenium, Rh rhodium, Pd palladium, Ag stand for silver, Cd cadmium, In indium, Sn tin, Sb antimony, Te tellurium, It stand for iodine, Xe is stand for xenon, Cs is stand for cesium, Ba is stand for barium. Now La is stand for lanthanum, Ce cerium, Pr is stand for parasodinium, Nd stands for neodymium, Pm promethium, Sm cerarium, Eu europium, Gd it stands for gadolinium, Tb is stand for terbium, Dy is symbol for disporium, Ho holmium, Er erbium, Tm it stands for thulmium, Yb ytterbium, Lu lutetium, Hf hafnium, Ta tantalum, W it stands for tungsten, Re rhenium, Os osmium, Ir it stands for iridium, Pt it stands for platinum, Au is gold, Ag is silver, Al it stands for thallium, Pd it stands for lead, Pb it stands for lead, Bi bismuth, Po polonium, At it stand for astinine, Rn it stand for radon, Fr is francium, Ra is radium, Ac it stand for actinium, Th it stand for thorium, Pa it stand for protactinum, U is the symbol for uranium, Np neptunium, Pu plutonium, Am americium, Cm curium, Bk its symbol for berkelium, Cf californium, Es einsteinium, Fm fermium, Md mendelium, No nobelium, Ir, Lr it stand for lawrencium, Rf rutherfordium, Db it stand for dubinium, Sg it stand for seaborgium, Bh borium, Sh it's the symbol for hertzium, Mt metadium, Ds is the symbol for dermestadium, Rg rostangium, Cn coppercium, Nh nihonium, Fl fellurium, Mc moscovium, Lv liver mausoleum, Ts tennessean, and Og it stand for organism. Now students, we have seen the modern periodic table, the elements which are present and the symbols of it. Now here it has the horizontal rows and the vertical columns. Now students, the horizontal rows are called periods. Now the numbers are from 1 to 7. The vertical column are called groups. They are numbered from 1 to 18 in the modern periodic table. Now these elements are named as per the IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Now students, in this IUPAC or IUPAC, this is a method of naming organic chemical compounds. It is a standard method which is accepted all over the world for naming the organic compounds, as it follows certain rules for naming organic compounds. if you see the modern periodic table, the boxes are formed at the intersection of periods and groups. See the periods and groups in the table. They are fixed for a particular individual elements. Now, at the bottom of the periodic table, below the main table are placed two series. Now you can see the two series that contains 14 elements each. So at the bottom of the periodic table, you can see the two series are present and they have the 14 elements each. Now these 118 elements that has been discovered till today are being placed in the modern periodic table, and IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, has approved the names and symbols of all these elements. Now students, see the first and the second group. These two groups on the left of the modern periodic table, it forms the S block. Study the names and the symbols of all these elements. Now from 13 to 18, these six groups on the right of the modern periodic table, now these they form the P block. Now next, from 3 to 12, these groups, they are the 10 groups. In the center of the modern periodic table, and they form the D block. Now at the bottom, you can see the two series which are present at the bottom, and they form the F block. So these are the distribution of the groups in the modern periodic table. Now let us move further and see about the periodic table and the electronic configuration. Now students, in 1869, Mendeleev put forth his periodic table. But at that time, the structure of the element was not known, but after the advancement and discovery of the quantum mechanical model of atom, the properties of the elements were correlated to the electronic configuration. And so, when elements are arranged in an increasing order of atomic number is represented by Z, periodicity is observed in the electronic configuration, which reflects in the modern periodic table. Now, the location of the elements in the modern periodic table is correlated to the quantum number of the last filled orbitals, means the orbitals which are present at the end, and how many electrons are present in that last orbital. Now let us move further and see about the electronic configuration in periods. Now see the modern periodic table over here. Now over here you can see the periods in the modern periodic table are numbered 1 to 7. See the figure. The electronic configuration is the distribution of electrons of an atom or a molecule in the atomic or the molecular orbit. Now in the period, the atomic number increases by 1, and 1 electron is added to the outermost shell, which forms neutral atom of the next element. Now students, if we see every period, it ends with a duplet. We can also say with two electrons. If we see the first period or period that ends with complete octet configuration, octet means having 8 electrons, of the valency cell, and the next period begins with addition of electrons to the next shell of the higher energy as compared to the previous one. Now here the periods are numbered from 1 to 7. The periodic number is same as the principal quantum number, that is n, of the outermost or the valency cell of the element. Now let us see about the first period. Now when we talk about the first period, the first cell includes two elements, that is hydrogen having atomic number 1 with electronic configuration 1s1, and helium has complete duplet with electronic configuration 2. Now let us see for the second period. The second period begins with lithium with atomic number 3 and electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s1, and it ends with neon with atomic number 10 and electronic configuration it has 1s2, 2s2 and 2p6. That is the electronic configuration. Now let us see about the third period. Now this third period, it includes 8 elements. It starts from Na, that is sodium, having atomic number 11, to argon with atomic number 18. Now this has a condensed electronic configuration. This condensed electronic configuration is neon, Ne, 3s from 1 to 2 and 3p from 1 to 6. Now let us see next one, that is about the fourth period. Now when we talk about the fourth period, it begins with filling of 4s subshell. Now let us start this with potassium, that is K, having atomic number 19 and electronic configuration is Ar, that is argon, 4s1, and calcium which has atomic number 20 and electronic configuration is Ar, that is argon, 4s2. Now these are the first two elements of the fourth period and are two elements of the S block. Now the 10 elements from scandium, that is Sc, with atomic number 21. It has electronic configuration of 4s2, 3d1, 2 zinc which has atomic number of 30, and it has the electronic configuration of AR, that is argon 4s2 3d 10. Now students, here there are 10 elements from the D block. Now 6 elements we start from gallium, that is Ga, having atomic number 31 and electronic configuration is Ar, that is argon 4s2 3d 10 and 4p1, to krypton with atomic number 36 and electronic configuration is argon, that is Ar 4s2 3d 10 and 4p6. Now here students, there are 6 elements from the P block. Now so the 4th period, it contains total of 2 plus 10 plus 6, that is total of 18 elements. Now let us start with the 5th period. Now this 5th period, if you see in the modern periodic table, just when you are reading this, keep the periodic table in front of your eyes so that the topic can be clear with you. Now just see the 5th period. Now this 5th period, it contains 18 elements with filling of electrons, and these electrons are filled in 5s, 4d and 5p subshell. Now this period, it begins by filling one electron to the s subshell of a new shell, and it ends with an element having complete octet, that is 8 electrons, or duplet, that it has 2 electrons. Now these cells are filled following the Aufbau principle. Now what is this Aufbau principle? Now when we say about the Aufbau principle, the Aufbau principle, it states that the electrons are filled in the atomic orbital of the lowest available energy and then to the higher level. So it states about the filling of the electron to the available energy, which starts from the lower one and then it goes to the higher one. Now so students, in today's topic of modern periodic table, as we have seen that there are 118 elements which has been arranged in this modern periodic table. So students, it's very necessary that you study the modern periodic table very thoroughly, as it is very important from your examination point of view and for your further studies. Now this Mendeleev, he prepared the modern periodic table, which consists of vertical groups and horizontal series, which is called as periods. Now this modern periodic table, it has horizontal rows and vertical columns, which are called as periods and groups. Now when we talk about periods, you can see in the figure, these periods, you can see they are the horizontal rows, and there are 7 periods in the modern periodic table. Now when we talk about groups, now these are the vertical columns, and there are 18 groups in the modern periodic table. Now when we see about the IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, now these 118 elements which we can see in the modern periodic table, these are been approved, named, and even the symbols are given by the IUPAC system. Now if we see overall, there are the four blocks. Now see the previous figure, and you can just see over there are four blocks: S block, P block, D block and F block. Now this S block, which is there, it is placed on the left hand side, having groups, that is from 1 and 2. Now this P block is placed on the right hand side from group 13 to 18, and in D block it is placed between S and P block from the group number, which is 3 to 12. Now if we talk about F block, this includes two series of 14 elements each, and it is placed at the bottom of the periodic table. Now from all these four blocks that we have seen, S and P block elements, they are called as the representative elements, since such element have the same number of outer shells to the number of periods. Now when we see about the electronic configuration in periods, we have seen that the period number is the same as the principal quantum number. The principal quantum number is given by n of the outermost valency shell of the element. Now we can see, we have seen about the periods: the first period, second period, third, fourth and sixth and seventh period. Now when we talk about sixth and seventh period, they are the longest period, having total number of 32 elements in each. Now students, this is a very important topic. So whenever you study this modern periodic table, go through the figure first, study it properly, study the symbol, study the name of the elements and their arrangement properly. So here we'll come to the end of today's lecture. Wish you all the best for your studies and see you all in the next lecture. Bye.